In this video, we have an Atwood machine with friction. So we have a 4 kilogram block sitting on this level surface. It experiences a static friction coefficient of 0.75, kinetic friction coefficient of 0.3. It's connected by a string to a hanging mass over a light frictionless pulley, and the size of the hanging mass is yet to be determined. In part A, we're asked to get the minimum value of that hanging mass that would cause this 4 kilogram block to break loose. So you can imagine if we put a very small mass and hung it off this string, it's not enough to break that larger block loose and start it sliding. We're trying to find exactly that cut point that causes it to break loose. Whenever you see that phrase breaking loose, you know we're talking about exactly the moment where the static friction force is at its maximum value. And that allows you to use the formula: static friction maximum value is the coefficient of static friction times the normal force. So we'll use that in a minute, but first let's get all our forces into the diagram. That hanging mass, little m, force of gravity down on that is little mg. The other force on that mass, the tension pulling upward. The tension in the string is the same at the other end. The reason this block is not accelerating in the static friction case is that my static friction force is balancing the force of tension by pointing to the left. And then gravity pulls down on this big m, with a force of big M times G, and I can just go ahead and get a number on that right now. That's 4 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared, and I get 39.2 newtons. The final force for our diagram is the normal force on big M pointing up. And because this is a level surface and there are no other forces with a vertical component acting on this mass, that's just going to be equal to the force of gravity down on that mass, guaranteeing that the net force in the y direction is equal to zero. So to figure out this question about the minimum hanging mass before the block breaks loose, we can start by saying that the tension in the string is equal to little mg. So I'm looking over here right now at that little mass. And because it's a static situation, in other words, nothing is moving, it means those two forces must be balanced. So we've got the tension in the string is equal to little mg. And then if I look at the analysis of my big M, again, it's a static situation. And T is pulling to the right, and this force of static friction is pulling to the left. And again, if we're right at the point where things are about to break loose, that static friction force is maxed out. So I can plug in that T is equal to little mg. Again, that's only true if the system is static. If it's accelerating, then the net force on that little mass is not zero, and I can't say that T is equal to mg. And then I plug in the formula for the max static friction, which is mu s times the normal force, and I'm able to solve for little m. So we plug in the static friction coefficient, we plug in the normal force that we computed already, we plug in G, and we get a mass of 3 kilograms that's going to cause this thing to break loose. In part B, we want to get the acceleration of the system if we use the hanging mass that we calculated in part A. So we're going to assume things have broken loose and begun to slide now. So even though that 3 kilograms is the maximum mass we can hang off without it breaking loose, even a billionth of a newton extra, just from a slight gust of wind or something, will break it loose. And after that, the kinetic friction coefficient is way smaller than the static friction coefficient. And this thing is going to slide and accelerate. So this is no longer a static situation. And that means that this tension in the string cannot be equal to little mg pulling down on that little mass. In fact, I know the system is accelerating downward. And that means little mg is bigger than the tension, so the net force points downward. One of the key points to analyzing Atwood machines that are accelerating is that we analyze each mass in a coordinate system where we use positive for the actual direction of the acceleration. So that's going to be downward for the hanging mass and rightward for the mass that's on the surface. Then we apply Newton's second law to each moving piece of the system, and it gives us a system of equations to solve, and we should be able to get the acceleration out of that. So I'll analyze little m first. Again, downward is going to be positive, and the net force is mg minus t. And net force is equal to the mass times acceleration. Then we do the same thing for the big mass. It has a force of t, the tension in the string, pulling to the right. It has a friction force pulling to the left, opposite the direction of the sliding. And now that's a kinetic friction force. So there's my net force, and that's equal to big M times A. I'll just stay symbolic for now. And what we do is we add the left-hand sides and the right-hand sides of these equations, and the t's are going to eliminate when we do that. So I get little mg minus Fk, the force of kinetic friction, is equal to little ma plus big ma. And I can go ahead and do some factoring while I'm at it. So I can get a symbolic solution for the acceleration. It's little mg minus Fk, all divided by the sum of the two masses. And again, we're using the 3 kilogram mass here. G is 9.8. Our force of kinetic friction is given by mu k times the normal force. So that's 0.3 for mu k. And the normal force again is 39.2 newtons. And the sum of the two masses is 3 kilograms plus 4 kilograms, or 7 kilograms. And we get an acceleration of 2.52 meters per second squared. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.